Hello everybody. In the present video lecture, we shall discuss the conductivity mechanism in metals, especially the classical free electron model. It was Drude and Lorentz, they proposed a model to explain the electrical conductivity in metals. And this model is popularly known as classical free electron model. In 1900, Drude proposed the model of electrical conduction applying the kinetic theory of gases. Drude was a German physicist who he lived in between 1863 and 1906. Later in 1905, this model was extended by H.A. Lorentz to establish the relation between thermal conductivity and the electrical conductivity of metals. Lorentz was a Dutch physicist who lived between 1853 and 1928, and he was also the Nobel Prize winner of 1902. As per this model, the metal consists of positively charged ion cores. So this is the positively charged ion core. This positively charged ion core is in turn made up of positively charged nucleus and the inner electrons. The positively charged nucleus and the inner electrons contains positively charged ion core. And these ion cores are fixed at the lattice points. The free electrons are free to move within the metal. Free electrons are nothing but valence electrons, which are loosely bound to the nucleus. You can see a sea of free electrons, and these free electrons are compared to the gaseous molecules. So this was the basic idea of Drude-Lorentz model or classical free electron model. In order to understand the classical free electron model, we need to define certain basic definitions, especially the mean free path. It is the average distance traveled by a free electron between any two successive collisions with the lattice ions. It is termed as mean free path. It is denoted by lambda and will be in the orders of nanometer. See, when you look at this figure, the free electron, they randomly move within the metal. The free electrons are moving in all possible directions. The free electron, they will collide with the positively charged lattice ion core and take a diversion and move in another direction. The average distance traveled by the free electrons between any two successive collision is called as mean free path. And it will be in terms of nanometer. Now, mean collision time. The average time lapse between any two successive collision of free electron with a lattice ion is called mean collision time. It is denoted by tau and will be in the orders of 10 to the power minus 14 second. Between any two successive collision, there is a time gap. And when you take average of such time gaps, then it will give what is called mean collision time, which is denoted by tau, and that will be in terms of 10 to the power minus 14 second. Now, we will try to understand what is thermal velocity. You know that metal consists of positively charged ion cores, and the valence electrons are loosely bounded, which are free to move within the metal. And these free electrons have gained velocity because of the temperature of the metal. And this velocity, what is called as thermal velocity. Thermal velocity, it is the average velocity of free electrons in the given material due to its thermal energy. At room temperature, the thermal velocity of an electron would be 116 kilometer per second or 10 to the power of 6 meter per second and is denoted by the symbol Vt. Note, the net thermal velocity of the electrons in any given direction is taken as zero. The net velocity of the free electrons in any given direction is considered as zero, because if the electron is moving in one direction, in this direction, forward direction, exactly there is another electron which is moving in the backward direction. If the electron is moving in the top direction, exactly there is an electron which is moving in the downward direction. As a result, the net velocity of the electrons in any given direction is considered as zero. Now, we will try to understand the definition drift velocity. The concept of drift velocity arises in the presence of electric field. In absence of the electric field, all electrons move in random direction, in all possible direction. But the moment electric field is applied to the metals, then all the free electrons, they try to move only in one direction. As you can see in this figure, all the electrons, they are moving more or less in the same direction. That too in the direction opposite to the application of the electric field. And this drift this velocity is called as drift velocity. In presence of an applied electric field, electrons have a small net component of velocity in the direction opposite to that of the applied field, which is called drift velocity. It is denoted by Vd and is of the order 10 to the power of minus 4 seconds. So this is a drift velocity concept, and this velocity is of very small order, 10 to the power of minus 4 seconds, because we are taking the net velocity in a particular direction. As a result, this will be always very small, of the order 10 to the power of minus 4 seconds, or sometimes millisecond. In the second figure, what you're going to see here is the electron is colliding with this lattice ion and moving forward to the next lattice ion. It is colliding with one more ion, and again it is taking a zigzag path, but as a result there is some net velocity in a particular given direction. That is called as drift velocity. Now try to understand what is relaxation time. It is the time taken by conduction electrons to relax to their initial equilibrium state after the removal of applied electric field. This is very simple. See, in this figure, you are seeing that all electrons are moving in one direction. They are drifting in one direction. There is some drift velocity. This is in presence of the applied field. But when the applied field is removed, all of a sudden the electron stop moving in particular direction, stop drifting in particular direction, they come back to their original random orientation. So what is the time taken by the free electrons to lose their drift velocity, to convert into a random velocity? And that particular time is called as relaxation time. Now, this free electron gas model is based on certain assumptions. The assumptions are, metal is assumed to be made up of positively charged lattice ions consisting of nucleus plus inner electrons. The second one, valence electrons are free to move within the metal. These sea of free electrons are compared to the gas molecules. Third, electrostatic forces between the free electrons and the ion core are negligible. Fourth, free electrons can't jump outside the metal because of potential barrier at the surface. Fifth, energies of the free electrons are distributed as per the Maxwell-Boltzmann distribution. See, based on these assumptions, they were able to derive the first mathematical expression for electrical conductivity in metals, thermal conductivity in metals. So these are the assumptions which led this theory to a certain degree of success. Expression for conductivity as per the classical theory. Conductivity sigma is equal to N E square tau R by M. This is the first ever mathematical expression for electrical conductivity in metals. Conductivity sigma is given in terms of N free electron concentration, E charge of the free electron, tau R relaxation time, M mass of the electron. Merits of this theory. It gave the first ever mathematical expressions for electrical and thermal conductivities of a metal. It gave a satisfactory explanation for Ohm's law of resistance. Third, it was used to explain the optical properties of metals. Now, we will come to the failures of classical free electron theory. It failed to explain specific heat capacity in metals. It did not give any explanation. Second, it failed to explain electrical conductivity in semiconductors and dielectrics. It did not throw light in the mechanism of conductivity in the case of semiconductors and dielectrics. Third, it failed to explain the photoelectric effect. It did not give any explanation for the photoelectric effect. Fourth, theory predicted incorrect temperature dependence of resistivity in metals. As per the theory, resistivity rho proportional to square root of absolute temperature. But experimentally, it is found that resistivity rho is proportional to temperature. And the last one, theory predicted higher conductivity for divalent zinc and trivalent aluminium than the monovalent copper and silver. So these are the failures of classical theory. Thank you.